Hello everyone, this is Isabel. I'm at Mobile World Congress 2022. It's day three, we're still going strong, and I'm joined by Howard Stevens, CEO of TOMIA, on the hot seat. Are you ready?
Certainly am, Isabel. Nice to be with you.
How's been your week so far?
Very busy, I'm pleased to say. It's been really, really good to be back in the show, meeting people physically, old friends and new's been really good. And we're extremely busy, so it's a really good week so far.
I agree, me too. It's very exciting. So I guess this week we're in Mobile World Congress, and of course we've heard a lot about 5G. And one of the things that will make 5G global is VoLTE roaming. I mean, at HOT Telecom, we've talked about VoLTE roaming for a long time. We've written articles, we've done statistics, but up to very recently, there wasn't that much traction with VoLTE roaming. But now that 5G is here, is that changing? Is VoLTE roaming finally happening?
Yeah, it's been interesting for us, actually, because if we had this interview this time last year, I don't think I could honestly have said to you that VoLTE roaming was really taking off. But the last 6 to 9 months has made a huge difference to it. I think it's really being driven by the shutdown of the American 3G networks, which has started and will conclude this year. Over the last 6 months, we've seen 10 plus projects kick off. Our pipeline for projects has more than doubled, and we're expecting to see an awful lot of activity right throughout the year for VoLTE roaming. So I think finally VoLTE roaming has actually arrived.
And I reflect that because we talked to lots of the operators and carriers, and I think even in the last few months, maybe in the last 6 months, that's where we've started a lot of traction happening. So VoLTE roaming, one buzzword. Second buzzword, IoT roaming. And IoT roaming will bring a lot of complexity. Mm. However, I believe that with complexity comes opportunities. So for the operators and carriers out there wanting to address this complexity, what should they do?
Yeah, well, the carriers are on a journey in terms of understanding IoT roaming. Some carriers have actually taken it really, really positively and aggressively and are driving a lot of enterprise business as a consequence of it. Some carriers are still, from a roaming point of view, trying to understand how many machines they have in their network. What do they do with it in terms of moving it forward strategically? But the one thing that is clear is that IoT roaming, a bit like VoLTE roaming, has actually started to really make a difference to people. So that is going to bring a lot of complexity. From our point of view in the roaming world, it means that an average carrier is probably going to go from managing 300 to 400 relationships with 2 or 3 parameters, so voice, data, and SMS, to managing potentially tens of thousands. What we're seeing in the market today is carriers doing individual agreements per line of business. So looking at containers, looking at solar panels, individual agreements going in. So that is going to ratchet up the complexity significantly. So carriers have actually got to look at automating an awful lot of their systems. They've got to integrate in between clearing and roaming to make the decision making significantly easier and much more effective. If they don't do that, they're going to generate all this positivity, but they're going to lose it in the complexity of making that work day to day.
And on top of that, even when you start looking, not just the technology, but the business models, you'll have to have multiple business models. So that will be a very challenging thing to address, but very exciting as well. So buzzword number three, A2P messaging, surprise, surprise. In the last few years, we've seen everyone, the operators, the carriers, jump on the A2P wagon. But it's true, it's a lot of growth there. However, addressing A2P messaging is not the same as A2P for a carrier, because you have to have a more agile, flexible, efficient business model. Mm-hmm. So how does TOMIA help carriers and operators address that?
Well, we've been in the voice business, I think as most people know, for many, many years. And we address a lot of the complexity around voice, the business-to-business relationship side, the routing side of it. And there are a lot of similarities between the voice side and SMS. So as carriers and enterprises are looking perhaps not to go through the aggregators, but go direct to each other, we've actually been able to transfer all of that understanding from a voice perspective and help the carriers simplify and manage all of that interaction in a much more efficient way. And we are seeing operators now looking very, very seriously at bringing this business back from the aggregator community and doing it direct. And we're working with many of the big tier ones on that now. So we can, again, we can help reduce the complexity for them.
Okay. So I guess you mentioned complexity. I think it's going to be, the future is complexity, 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 with all the buzzwords we touched on. IoT, A2P, VoLTE, 5G, for sure. However, carriers, and they have a, you know, they have a, in their DNA, they're able to simplify the equation, or at least they have the tools to do so. How does TOMIA play its role in all of that? How can you enable carriers and operators to simplify all of this complexity?
Yeah, well, I think it comes through two things, which is integration and automation. Because again, in order to have the decision making that the carriers are going to need to actually make these things work in real time, you have to integrate systems together. And fundamentally, from our point of view, it's integrating clearing and network roaming. We're the only vendor in the market that actually has both of those lines of business together. And we have integration points already, which will help the carriers simplify that decision making as they look at their potentially tens of thousands of agreements moving in real time. So it is all about having the systems in place to simplify the decision making and then make that happen in real time across their networks. And we're in the best place to do that for them.
So a lot of exciting times ahead for everyone, and you including.
Yes, absolutely. And I think as we all start to get back on planes, we all start to roam again, that's going to give the impetus for the carriers, I think, to look again at investing rather than potentially just holding back on money. And we're starting to see that happen as well. So, yeah, so I think we're the whole industry, but particularly to me, we're in for a very exciting FY22.
Well, oh, wow, FY22, that's a cool term. Okay, I'm keeping that one in my little book for future use. Howard, thank you so much for a great interview. I think we've covered a lot of hot topics today, important topics. So thank you very much for being on my hot seat today.
That's a pleasure. Nice to see you again, as always.
Everyone, thank you for watching, and until my next hot shot.